Hello, friends, dear ones. Thank you for being here for watching this, whether you're going to be with me live or you're going to watch this later in our group, Manifest the Miraculous Community. And I'm continuing on with the Course in Miracles. If you haven't purchased your copy, it's $18 from Amazon. Get the one that has the text, the workbook for students, and the manual for teachers. It's complete. And I told my husband this morning, this is like a life manual. It is been so endearing to us for our relationship. So if you have someone special, we're teaching these principles to the kids, and really it is changing us from the inside out, and the revelations that we've experienced every day have been nothing short of miraculous, quite frankly. And so I wanted to read this one little piece that it says to you, says to all of us, which basically sums up this entire manual of life. And it says, "Nothing real can be threatened. Nothing unreal exists. Herein lies the peace of God." So let me repeat that. Nothing real can be threatened. Nothing unreal exists. Herein lies the peace of God. So in our quest for search of peace and in search of fulfillment in our human experience, what is real and what is not real? What in the heck does that even mean, right? So, from what I understand, what is real are the qualities of God. What is real is the mind of God. What is real is the characteristics, the personality, and the what God is made of. And because we are an extension, if you start viewing yourself as an extension of the Creator, you understand that we are to have the mind of God. We are to have the eyes of God, the ears of God, the heart of God, the essence of God, which truly that is what's real, and that's what you already are. I realize I've been teaching some things wrong all these years, talking about transformation, and it's hard to transform. And yes, that can be true because we get used to habits and patterns in our life, and they take a stronghold, and it's directly correlated to the ego mind. But what I've come to learn in my own spiritual growth is that it's not so much about change as much as it is about remembrance. Remembering the qualities of God that live within you, the characteristics of God that you are, the abundance of the universe is yours. Like all of these things are what we are to remember about ourselves. And that is the journey. That is the transformation. So, with that said, I want to go into the fourth principle of miracles because we are here to not only embrace the miraculous in our life, but to become miracle makers in your own life, but in the lives of others. And over and over and over again, the lesson is about giving. It is not about getting. So when you are thinking about what you want that you don't have, remember that we give first that of which we want to experience. So if you want more abundance, think of ways to be more charitable. If you want more love in your life and more relationships, go be loving and establish relationships. Go give love to other people. That is how we open up that cycle and that circulation, and that's how it comes forth. So, with that said, principle number four, all miracles mean life. And God is the giver of life. His voice will direct you very specifically. You will be told all you need to know. That one's like, ah, Teresa, because I've got an inquisitive mind. I want to know everything. So this is really cool that, we're going to be told everything that we need to know. And I do know that there are some things that are going to be left for us to learn as we transition into the life after life, and that is to remain a mystery. And one of the reasons why we have some of the a little bit of mystery is because we're supposed to build our faith in what we can't see and what we don't know. We can't visualize in our own, or we can't see it in our reality. We have to visualize it, seek it out, knock for the door to be answered, ask so we shall receive. And it's about building that trust with the Creator. Okay, now principle of miracles number five. Miracles are habits and should be involuntary. They should not be under conscious control. Consciously selected miracles can be misguided. And so for that, and my miracle just walked in the door, my husband's here, is that sometimes we say, oh, I want this particular job. And when in fact, there is something a miracle of a job opportunity or a career or something of that nature that is better suited for you that God knows and is working behind the scenes to bring to your life. When I was manifesting my great mate in Victor, I had past loves that I could have made it all about them to bring them back to me, but I didn't do that. What I did was I allowed God, I surrendered to the universe to bring to me the one that was perfect for me and my ideal match. So you can let go of trying to control the miracles. And how you do that is by being in trust. Like I told you before, there's faith and then there's a belief. And then there's knowingness. But above all else is trust. Trust and know that I am God is really the lesson here and in this particular principle, which is, you know, trust that there is a miraculous unfoldment in your life. Your job is to trust it. Your job is to believe in it. Your job is to have faith for it. And your job is to resist. Well, what we resist persists. So we know that we have fear. We recognize that fear comes along, but we have that moment of recognizing, oh, I'm feeling fearful that might not happen. That I might not have my dreams come true. So you give that fear the acknowledgement. You give it a voice. You hear it. You listen to it. But then you say, however, I am an extension of the Almighty. I am an extension of the Creator of all things. And it is absolutely nothing for my Creator and I to create these wonderful miracles in my life. And so then you start affirming what you know is true because that's the only thing that's real. The rest of it is an illusion. The fear, the doubt, the worry, the mistrust, the distrust, the trepidation, all of that does not exist in the mind of God. When we are giving in to fear, which we will, you know, when we're enlightened to the point where we never feel any of those things, we'll be on the other side. But we will feel those fears. We will have those doubts come every now and then. So just know that it's coming, but you have a choice. As long as we're in these human bodies, we are not robots. We actually choose from second to second, nanosecond to nanosecond, how we're going to think, feel, and express and be in this world. So make the choice to align again with those characteristics of God because that is your identity. That is your power. That is where the miracles will manifest in your life. I have a couple of announcements. Oh, yes. Please join me if you're in the Bay Area or anywhere close. March 3rd, 7:30 to 9 p.m., I'll be giving a free lecture where I'll be going over the basics of a miraculous mindset. And then following day on Sunday, March 4th from 1 to 5 is my workshop. And we will be doing that at East West Bookshop, the largest metaphysical bookshop in the entire country, where they host the greats like Dan Millman and other amazing healers and authors and teachers and lecturers. So I am so honored to be hosting that workshop. It's going to be fun. It's going to be interactive. And you're going to get to listen on and learn about how to really evoke the miraculous in your life. We'll post that in here so you can get your tickets. It's $40 for the workshop, $50 the day of. The lecture is free. Come to both. You are going to get value out of it. So that is one thing. I would love to meet you in person. The people that I've been working with in the Bay Area, if I don't know you, that's okay. Come and see me at the workshop. It'll be really super fun and informative and miraculous. I'm praying about it already. Also, if you haven't joined my Manifest Miraculous community with Patreon, be looking for that link in here. I want to start those classes right away. However, I will be traveling for 2 weeks in March, so we can do some classes up until then, and then it'll be upon my return. So be looking for that. Click on the link so you can learn more about becoming a Patreon. Okay, my lovelies, have a wonderful day, and reach out to me if you are in despair. If you don't seem to be able to clear away the muck and find the mind of God within you, then reach out to me so that we can work together, okay? God bless. Take care.